Why do you think your music has become so embedded in our culture?
I don't know. I think, first of all, because it you know, I mean, if I knew that, I would start my own record company tomorrow morning. And I think it was the way the songs we did were written. The blue-collar guy, the guy that went to work, and whether he worked construction or drove a truck or a cab or whatever, we said things the way I felt he might want to say it. We never tried to be anybody else but who we were, and it was terrific.
Frankie Valli of the Four Seasons is one of the most instantly recognizable lead singers of all time. All you have to do is hear him sing to recognize him. He blessed the world with his music, and in many ways he's been blessed. He's been able to reach superstardom doing what he loves, and he's had 9 beautiful children. But he still had to overcome tragedy. Not all of his children lived long. One of the ones that did became his enemy. Keep watching to learn why Frankie Valli has a restraining order against his own son. Frankie's love life. The Four Seasons were relatable enough to appeal to everyone. They weren't just a boy band with a swarm of female fans. As Frankie said himself,
a lot of groups had girl fans, and the guys that they were going with weren't that crazy about the groups because the girls were crazy about the guys that were in the group. We had a different kind of thing going. Girls liked us and guys liked us, so the guys would also come to see our shows.
That didn't mean the charming and famous Frankie had any trouble finding women. He's had 4 wives in his lifetime. Mary Mandel. Frankie married his first wife, Mary Mandel, in 1957. This was before his band had even changed their names to the Four Seasons and become a success. She already had a daughter, Celia, from a previous relationship. They had 2 more daughters, Antonia and Francine. They kept their relationship out of the spotlight, but not all of it. Parts of it got into the biopic musical Jersey Boys. Their granddaughter, Olivia Valli, performed in the 2019 production. She said, quote, "I love honoring my family 8 times a week, doing what I love." Frankie and Mary divorced after 13 years of marriage in 1971. The death of Celia and Francine put a strain on their marriage. MaryAnn Hannigan. Frankie then married MaryAnn Hannigan in 1974. They met in 1970, but he admitted, quote, "She was a pal when I needed one, but because I'd been hurt before, I resisted what I was feeling about her." Their relationship didn't last forever. They divorced 8 years later in 1982. Randy Cloese. Frankie married his 3rd wife, Randy, in 1984. They had 3 sons, Frankie Valli Jr., and twins Emilio and Brando. They got divorced after 20 years of marriage in 2004. It was his most contentious divorce. The couple disputed whether a life insurance policy he bought in 2003 should be considered community property because Randy was a beneficiary of the policy. The court ruled in his favor because he was a partial owner after the divorce. Randy died of leukemia at age 54 on July 4, 2014. She left her $6 million Malibu home to her 3 sons. It was torn up by the Woolsey wildfire in 2018. Jackie Jacobs. Frankie married Jackie Jacobs on June 26, 2023. They met in 2007 but didn't officially begin dating until 2015. He thought at first that after all his previous failures, he might not be cut out for marriage, but he changed his mind. His social media team congratulated him with a post on Instagram. Frankie said it was great to have found love again so late in life.
Which one is your favorite that we have a short? Do you have a favorite?
I don't really have a favorite.
There's just too many hits.
It's like saying you have these 9 kids now. Which one of these kids are your favorite?
More on Frankie's kids. Music is Frankie's first love, and he's always put it above everything. The only thing that matters remotely as much to him is his children. He's never picked a favorite, but he has spoken about his love for them. Celia. Celia Sabin Valli was born in 1954. She was Frankie's stepdaughter, born to Mary Mandel and her ex-husband. She died in February 1980. It was the result of a freak accident where she fell down the fire escape. Rick Elise, the writer of Jersey Boys, explained the reason he didn't include her death in the musical. He said, quote, "If you put that in the show, no one would believe it. It would be too horrible and seem like it was fiction." Frankie also spoke about her in a 2013 interview with Billboard. He said that a tragedy as deep as losing a child is, quote, "not something you ever, ever get over. It's just not supposed to be that way." Antonia. Antonia Tony Valli grew up in New Jersey. She married Gary Pulci, drummer of the Four Seasons, in 1987. Tony says it was love at first sight, but Frankie didn't approve. He knew Jerry was a great musician and drummer, but he didn't want his daughter to marry him, much less any musician. He eventually came around to the idea. Tony and Jerry got married and gave Frankie 2 grandchildren before splitting up. Olivia was born in 1993 and Dario born in 94. Olivia remembers being entranced by her father's early performances. She became a stage performer. Frankie was thrilled when she became part of the Four Seasons musical. Emilio and Brando. Twins Emilio and Brando were born in 1995 to Frankie and Randy. They spent their early years on the road, which he said was great for their social skills. They also picked up their father's interest in music. They both play the drums. Brando has released singles such as Imagine and Numb With You. Emilio developed an interest in film. He studied at the Los Angeles Film School and worked on productions like Ray Donovan and Agent Carter. He seems to be putting it behind for the moment because he's working as a realtor in Malibu, California. The twins and his wife Jackie also joined him for his Hollywood Walk of Fame ceremony. He said during his acceptance speech, quote, "This is really a highlight of my life, especially having my sons here and my wife sitting right there." Francine Valli. Francine was born to Frankie and Mandel in Newark in 1960. She attended Bloomfield High School. She got the family musical gene. She wanted to cultivate a musical career and was even scheduled to tour with her father. Francine died of an accidental drug overdose at age 20 on August 16, 1980. Frankie had only had 6 months to grieve her sister Celia at the time. It was so difficult, he dealt with a bout of substance abuse despite giving up alcohol years earlier. Francine's death is included in Jersey Boys. Frankie said, quote, "The first time I saw that, it was incredibly difficult. And for many times after that. That lives with you forever. She died a long time ago, but I often imagine what it would be like if she were alive. She had a wonderful voice." The musical's writer said, "What most affected me was watching a man watching the death of his own child on stage. I saw him cry." Francesco Valli Jr. Francesco Valli Jr. was Frankie's first son with Randy, born in 1988. He was an actor who appeared in shows like Full House and movies such as The House Bunny and Reach Me. His parents' contentious divorce was tough on him. It led to a strained relationship with his family and an opioid addiction. Past court struggles. The Valli family has gone to court more than once. Emilio and Brando sued Francesco. They said he made it impossible to rent out the home their mother had given them. They did sign a lease, but Francesco threatened to move in and disturb the tenants, who had already moved in at $20,000 a month. The restraining order. Frankie struggled to stay on the straight and narrow in his early days in the projects. In that more conservative time, he worried it could ruin the career he'd worked so hard to build. He said,
I look at my life and think about how lucky I really was that I didn't end up in the trunk of a car or in jail or whatever. It was just a hard time where all you had were dreams. And in order to make a dream come true, boy, you couldn't be in a better country than being here in America.
Frankie has also suffered tragedy from his children using drugs. Emilio and Frankie got a temporary restraining order against Francesco. It orders him to have no contact with his father or brother. He must stay 100 yards away from their homes, cars, and workplaces at all times. The order alleges he attempted to break into their home and threatened to kill Frankie and Emilio. It also alleges he owes his brothers tens of thousands of dollars. The family says this is part of an unfortunate pattern. Francesco is addicted to opiates and has destroyed their property and stolen from them before. Frankie had been providing him with support for a while. He said it was dependent on his son going to a treatment program and getting the help he needs. That only made him angrier. Francesco's threats got worse. He also kept attempting to get Frankie's property to sell. Now it's time to hear from you. What's the most surprising part of this story? Let us know in the comments section below.